Sus, I just had a whole makeup error. This was supposed to be here. It's your girl Janellian and I am back with another video. Today I'm going to be doing a chit chat get ready with me to create this gorgeous look. I'm going to do a full beat along with doing a full outfit for you all, how I put everything together. Also, I'm going to do 5 reasons why your channel isn't growing, sis. Like, everyone wants to know what it is about their channel that's preventing them from getting to 1,000 subscribers, hitting 500 subscribers, stuff like that. Like, people want to know what it takes to hit that mark. I'm here to help you with that. I feel like everyone wants to know those answers because it's such a, what is those things called? Rubik's Cube? When it comes to YouTube, I feel like that's what it's like. Like, everyone's trying to figure out what it takes to grow your channel and get to at least 1,000 subscribers, the mark of getting monetized and stuff like that. So I feel like those are the main questions people have. It's like, what is it that I'm doing wrong that's preventing my channel to get to this point? I hope this will get your channel growing. More than likely it will, because these are just things that people need to do and pay attention to when it comes to YouTube, because I feel like these are very important tips. Number one, which is the obvious, I feel like everyone knows this one, not having a good banner for your channel. That is like key, sus. Like, you have to have a very good banner and thumbnail when it comes to your YouTube channel, because if your channel doesn't look like you put the effort into it, not saying that those channels can't grow, but it helps a lot once you put the effort into your banner and your thumbnail. Now, I do know that there's people on Instagram and maybe some people on some Facebook pages that will make banners for you. There are people who charge for stuff like that and very reasonable pricing as well. Like, I know some that may start at probably $10, $15, $25 and up. So yeah, get you a banner made. You want to make sure that your banner looks extremely good. Basically, tell them the story about yourself when it comes to your banner. I feel like your banner should have what it is that you do. Like, if you're gonna do a beauty channel, interior designing channel, a gaming channel, makeup channel, fashion channel, whatever channel you have, that needs to be within your banner, as well as, which I need to do myself for the what I'm about to say now, needing to have the days that you will be uploading, days they can expect your videos, if you have any particular days or what day of the week you do your videos. I feel like that is very important. Excuse me, I'm gonna be having to skip a lot. I'm already knowing, because talking and doing my makeup is like, bruh. You want to make sure that your banner tells a little about you and your channel. Maybe throw some pictures in there, or a cartoon of yourself, or something that just screams what your channel is about, so they could get a general idea of what your channel will be about if they so happen to come across one of your videos. And your thumbnail needs to 100% relate to your video. Like, don't put unnecessary thumbnails. Your thumbnails need to be very crisp and clear. One app that I use to edit my thumbnail is right behind. Another app being Facetune. So those are 2 apps that I use as far as making my thumbnails. There are other apps you can use as well, but those are pretty good apps that you can use as far as making a thumbnail and to have your channel looking good. As well as another app, which is PixArt. That is a really good app as far as creating a thumbnail too. So you want your thumbnail to pretty much be what your channel is about. You want it to scream out, come watch my video, because a lot of people will watch your video just off the thumbnail. Like, sus, like, that thumbnail just screamed, come watch me. A lot of videos I tend to watch based off people's thumbnails, so you do want to make sure that you create a thumbnail. Some people don't even put thumbnails, and that is what you're doing wrong. Definitely put a thumbnail within your videos. Number 2, I feel like it's also extremely obvious, which is something a lot of people don't do when it comes to YouTube. Like, when starting off, a lot of people do not do this, but not posting consistently. I've just gotten to the point where I post consistently. I don't have a set date yet, but I'll probably have one by tomorrow of what days I upload. But I do try to upload twice a week. If not twice a week, I always upload once a week. That is people's issue when it comes to YouTube, not posting consistently. What's best is to have an exact day of when it is you'll be uploading, because people like consistently. Like, for example, when it comes to kids, if you don't set kids on a routine as far as like making them breakfast in the morning and stuff like that. Let's say your child or kids have a certain nap time that they go to sleep. If they're not taking that nap, it throws them off and then they're all over the place. So you have, I hope this relates to what I'm saying, but you have to be consistent because people like consistency. People will stop watching you if you're not uploading consistently. Meaning, if you're gonna upload once a week on Monday, you need to upload once a week on Monday. If people come to your channel on Monday and seeing that there's no video there, they're not gonna keep necessarily checking. They might check back Tuesday to see if it's there by then. But if there's no video there, no one is going to just hunt you down necessarily to watch your videos because they're expecting that date that you set, you know? So being consistent is very important, as well as setting dates. I'm working on setting dates myself. I see people do it, and it's crazy how much it works. It really does work. I've seen it work for other people. So that's what I'm about to do, okay? Listen to me, sis. Set your dates. Number three. Oh my goodness, I feel like this one should have been number one or number five, the most important. Like, I feel like this one is just extremely important. Your channel is all over the place. You can't, I mean, you can. It may not get you anywhere, but you can't have a channel that is all over the place. Reason being is because people come to your channel for a particular reason. Let's say you might be a comedian, you might be funny. They're coming to see funny videos. They're not coming to see you do your makeup. They're not coming to see you clean your house. People are coming to your channel for a particular reason. There's reasons why people subscribe to your channel. So let's say one of your videos blew up being a funny video. And then after you do that funny video, all of a sudden, oh, you're doing all makeup videos. That's not why that person subscribed to your channel. Let's say you're doing all makeup videos, then all of a sudden you switch to just being a cooking show. People may watch it, but that's not why people necessarily watch it. You might just lose some views. So when your channel is all over the place, it throws people off. You need to set a particular channel that you want to have. If you want to have a cooking channel and a beauty channel, do it separately. Or have a separate section within your YouTube channel. YouTube has it where you can separate your particular videos. You can do vlogs. You can have it set for makeup. You can have it set for cooking. Like, do it organized. Like, make it where people could come to your channel and look for particular videos if you want to do cooking and makeup on your channel. If you want to do gaming and art on your channel. Like, make it organized. But other than that, I say do two separate channels if you want to do, you know, that kind of thing. And just recommend it on your particular channel that may have more subscribers something like that for people to go watch it on that channel, you know? I've actually just got the niche of sticking to one particular thing when it comes to YouTube because I was doing that as well, which I realized was a problem. I was doing clothing hauls and pranks and challenges, and it made it all over the place because people are not watching my channel with all those different particular topics. Some people come to beauty channels and fashion channels because they want their wardrobe to look like that, or they want to shop on those particular websites. They're not coming back on your channel to watch a prank. They want to know more ideas or more shopping tips you may have for them. Definitely stop being all over the place with your channel. Sus, I just had a whole makeup era. This was supposed to be here. So another thing, which is number four, I see a lot of people may not either do or they're not doing it properly. Not creating the right hashtags and or title. You have to put proper hashtags on your channel. You can't sit there and have a gaming channel and then put whatever is popular on YouTube right now. That's not how that works. And you can't have a channel and think you're just gonna put a bunch of celebrity names and people is gonna click on your channel. The purpose of having hashtags is so that people can easily find your channel. Let's say people look up five reasons their channel isn't growing. I'm doing a makeup combination along with telling people what they're doing wrong on their channel. I'm going to put five reasons why you're not growing on YouTube. That's going to be one of the popular hashtags and what makes sense to my channel. I'm not going to put makeup of the day while I'm talking about how to grow a YouTube channel. Now I can put both because they both relate. So what I'm saying is make sure that you're putting the right hashtags or even putting hashtags period, because how are people going to find your channel if you're not putting hashtags on your channel? If you're doing a makeup video, now it's possible you can be discovered, but it makes it harder for you to be discovered when you're not applying hashtags to your videos. So let's say I do a makeup video and just upload it and not put hashtags. How do I expect for Keisha or Kiana or anyone to find your channel if you're not putting in what they're looking for? Let's say Kiana or whatever is looking for a makeup tutorial. If you're not putting makeup tutorial or something related to it within your title and our hashtag, how is she gonna find you? It's like very impossible to find you. So you definitely want to make sure that you're putting proper hashtags and creating proper titles for your channel. Like, you see it all the time. A lot of people feel like, oh, I don't need to put, this is not the right color I'm using. Whatever, it'll work for today. The last one, which I think I'm gonna do a bonus one because I just thought of another one off the top of my head just now. But number five, you're not being yourself. I see that all the time. People watch other YouTubers and get the inspiration from them and then try to completely mock what it is they just watched. No, please do not do that. Please be yourself on your YouTube channel. Reason being is because people are subscribing to something new. They don't want to see a remock of some other YouTuber, okay? They don't want to see, if they want to see that person, they'll go watch that person, okay? You want to be unique when it comes to YouTube, because a lot of times that's how your channel flop. And by you not being yourself, your channel flop as well, because you can't keep up this image of trying to be someone else and trying to create exactly what it is they're doing. So what you want to do, and I had to learn that the hard way, okay? You want to be yourself when it comes to YouTube. People want to get to know you. You want to show your personality 100% on your YouTube channel. No one is coming to your channel to watch somebody else's. They're not. So you want to know exactly what it is you want people to know about you, and be that person 100% on your YouTube channel. And it comes off natural because you're so used to being you. The same way you are with your friends, your family, and your cousins or best friends or whatever, the same way you act with them is what you need to show on YouTube, because no one wants to see a fake. I didn't come to Bianca's page to watch Tiana Taylor. If I want to see Tiana Taylor, and I'm saying that like Tiana Taylor got a YouTube, if she does, shout out to you, girl. But if I wanted to see Tiana Taylor, I would go watch Tiana Taylor. I'm not coming to watch you be somebody else. I'm just not. So I subscribe to people based off their personality, their energy in their videos, how entertaining they are. Even if I'm watching like a self-help video. Sorry. What was I saying? Even if I'm watching a video to benefit me in the long run, I want to see that person's personality as well, because it keeps me in tune. Let's say you're in school, you're in high school, or you're in elementary school, or middle school, whatever it is. When you're in class, don't you get bored when you have, let's say you have a math teacher who makes math 100% amazing all the time, but once you leave math, you gotta go to science, and your science teacher is a drag, and your history teacher is extremely boring? Sus, that's just what I mean. Like, you're sitting in that class waiting for it to be over, so you'll want to click off simply because that they're not keeping you in tune. Like, they're not keeping you entertained throughout the entire video, which is a problem. So if you're not keeping the people entertained, no one's gonna want to watch you. So definitely show your personality. If you're pretty laid back, some people like laid back people. If you're super hilarious, people love hilarious people. Show that within your videos. Don't shy up on camera, which I know, but just very hard in the beginning, because a lot of people tend to go in their shell when it comes to YouTube, because you feel like you're talking to a crowd of people because there's a camera in your face, which is 100% understandable. I'm just getting out of the place where I feel scared and shy in front of the camera simply because I've been doing YouTube for a couple of years now. So I get it. I definitely understand 100%. So if you feel like that, practice talking in the mirror, practice recording yourself so you can go back and watch it. Even if you're not gonna upload it, just practice, because you want to show your best. Like, don't come off shy on YouTube, because it's not entertaining at all. It's not. People want to see your personality. Be yourself. Like, people love that. Like, don't be shy. Like, you're not getting on here singing. If you are, shout out to you. Show your best vocals. Don't shy up on them. Yeah, people want to see the best of you on your channel. So this is a bonus one. Oh my goodness. When I say, I absolutely can't stand when people do this. Like, stop doing. Okay, so the eyelashes that I'm getting ready to put on really quickly, these are my eyelashes that I sell on my website, which is called BBJ Lashes, and the back of it has my Instagram along with my website. So feel free to get these eyelashes on my website. Right now I am putting on the style icon. Okay, so that is the style. This is how they come. Excuse me for it falling off, I just was taking them off. But this is how they come. Follow for follow, subscribe for subscribe, like for like, comment for comment. Stop doing that, sis. Like, that is my biggest pet peeve. It'll get you subscribers, but a lot of times those people unsubscribe and they're not watching your videos anyway. And YouTube pretty much put those comments and stuff as spam and stuff, so it'll never show up on your channel. YouTube set it to a point where they know fake subscribers and stuff like that. Like, they know if you're not watching the videos and stuff like that, if people are just subscribing to your channel, like, YouTube got this to a science. Like, stop doing that. On top of the fact, not only do you need subscribers, but you also need 4,000 watch hours. It's not where you just need subscribers now or a certain amount of views. Like, now you need 4,000 watch hours, not minutes, hours, and 1,000 subscribers. But if you might have a problem with getting those watch hours, because just because people subscribe to your channel doesn't mean that they're going to actually watch your channel. It's a waste of time. And a lot of the times YouTube do like this overall, this whole swipe out where they go through and see like your robot subscribers and they'll delete them. So that is all that I have. I just did a simple look today. Kind of overdid it on the contouring and the glitter, but hey, it is what it is today. So let me go ahead and create a look, a final look. Let me go ahead and create a final look so that you all can see how this looks with an entire outfit. I'm gonna go ahead on my vlogging camera now so y'all can see what I'm gonna put on to take some pictures for my Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, if you want to see this look in a cute outfit on Instagram, go ahead and subscribe to me right now. I mean, subscribe that too, but go ahead and follow me on Instagram right now, which is beautybyjanelle_, and follow me so you can always see when I'm uploading some cute looks or doing some cute IGTV videos or some reels. Like, I really like reels. I like that they came up with that. Off topic, but yeah, go ahead and follow me on Instagram. Let me get some looks sorted. Okay, so I pretty much know that I'm about to put on this jacket, which I received from Shein. Shout out to them. I'll have my discount code down in the links below so you can see. So I'm gonna put on this jacket, take a picture with this, and I'm trying to see. I'm thinking about doing like a romper or something like that to go with it. I'm not exactly entirely sure. There we go. Good lighting. Not entirely sure what it is I want to pair with that. Maybe I should do like this tube top with these black joggers. I'm thinking of doing that with some boots or maybe some heels. That'd be cute. Maybe I should do right those with these heels. Maybe. I'm gonna see what I end up doing. Yeah, I have to look within my shoes because I have a couple of shoes that I can actually do with that. Maybe I'll do a completely all black look and then toss that jacket on. That'd be cute. Like, maybe if I did like these heels, which I got from Akira. I'ma see. I'ma put it together and then you all will see the final look. And then you go over to my Instagram so you can see exactly how the pictures turned out, okay? So let me just get right into it and get ready. Okay, so this is my final look. I'm going to go ahead and take some IG pictures in this. It looks crazy to me just in the mirror. Reason being is because I should have got this jacket in a smaller size. You know, after I had my surgery procedure. You go ahead and watch that too. I'll provide the link above. This is what I end up pairing it with. Exactly what I showed you. These black boots with these joggers and this tube top. So that is the final look. It's gonna look really cute on IG, so go ahead and check that out on my channel. So I have my little setup here in order for me to take my pictures. Stay tuned for that. Once again, go ahead and follow me on Instagram so that you can see these pictures. Please do me a favor, and if you haven't already, please do me a favor and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click the bell notification so you always see when it is I am uploading, and I will catch you all in my next video. Peace.